At Landgraf Chocolate, they make beautiful small batch handcrafted chocolates, homemade fillings with fresh ingredients. Each chocolate is a work of art and well worth the calorie splurge. Landgraf Chocolates is a family business. We've got Michael Jr., and he has learned all your chocolate trade from the master.
From the master over there.
And you know, you're also the bread chef. You're the chocolate chef. I mean, you've got it going on. Now, where did you begin your chocolate journey?
We started chocolate at, if some of you folks will remember, Shelton Matthews down on Market Street in Boardman there. A lot of history back there. We're friends with Don Matthews, the founder of that.
I mean, those were so beautiful. I mean, you know, and yours are too. I mean, there is truly an artistry that goes into it. I mean, especially your colored ones.
Yeah.
How do you get the different colors, Michael?
It's basically like a special food coloring in the we hand paint it into the molds before you put in the chocolate. It doesn't affect the taste or anything. It just makes them look really, really nice. It's like an extra step, but it makes them look really pretty.
And the chocolates are pure for like your dark. What kind of blend are you looking for when you make those?
Our chocolates we import from Belgium raw. We temper that here in our machines. We're using in the low 60s for our dark chocolate, 60% cocoa mass, and our milk chocolate is Belgium as well. It's around 37% cocoa mass.
Was it a lot of hit or miss when you guys were coming up with your recipes? Did you just sit around and like eat chocolate all day and say like, well, this has a nice mouth. Oh, this like melts nicely. What are you looking for?
We actually had a day where we met this guy that was like a chocolate salesman, and he brought a bunch of stuff in over at the bread shop, and my dad, myself, and then Russ, the one guy that bakes for us, we were just trying all this stuff.
This was your scientific panel?
Yeah. It was three of us and 100 different kinds of chocolate. So then we actually got this stuff in the mail. We ordered it separate from the stuff that guy brought us. We just knew that it's what we wanted. Like all three of us agreed that it was just really good and the flavor that we wanted, and yeah.
How do you get it to be so glossy? Why is it so, yours is so pretty and shiny. How do you do that?
That's just the chocolate being in really good temper and then the room being the right conditions. So we keep the room at 68 degrees all the time, like no humidity.
Yeah, it's really nice here. I mean, it's really cool.
So we just keep the temperature like really consistent, and then the chocolate tempering machines that we have are great. They hold the chocolate in perfect temper, so then when you mold it every time, it's really consistent. Like just consistency with the temperature and how you handle the stuff.
You're not in the wine business, are you?
I can't, no. I wish. I just found the coolest looking bottle I could find. But
that is a really nice idea, though.
Yeah, like for corporate gifts or like just for people, you don't know what the heck to get them for Christmas, you can pick four different pieces of chocolate and it'll hang on any wine bottle. So it's a nice little presentation.
That is a cute idea.
Yeah.
And wine and chocolate do go together.
Perfect mix, right?
Now, so what is this called?
This is just our 12-piece box. One thing that we do here, we let you pick your own assortments. I don't do pre-packaged assortments because everybody likes different stuff. And we don't want you to open up a box and have like three of the pieces that you really don't want, you know?
Yes.
So it like personalizes it a little bit more. That's just a 12-piece box. I've also got 6-piece boxes. Same kind of deal, just smaller. It looks
so
like a little necklace.
It's not by the pound, it's by the piece.
Yeah, exactly. Like the 12-piece box is a little bit over a half pound.
Okay.
So like, yeah, and all of our pieces are slightly different sizes. Then that's like a little, a 2-piece box. And this has actually been pretty popular with for bridal shower favors or...
Wait, that's a good idea.
Yeah, we did them last week for a rehearsal dinner for like the favors at everybody's spot.
So these are like your Willy Wonka bars?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they're cool different chocolate bars.
The golden ticket. And it's
there you go. Yeah, so we sell these in our store every day. We have a bunch of different kinds of nuts and stuff like that in them. And then we've got a few different places in town that you can buy them to. Branch Street Coffee, High Octane Coffee, and then Pressed, which is a little cafe place on YSU's campus. They all carry these. We do all the bars in milky and dark. And the cool thing too is the dark chocolate bars, they're all actually totally vegan. There's no milk product in it, which is even most dark chocolates do have a little bit of
a milk product in there.
Perfect. For vegans.
So vegans and then anybody that's like lactose intolerant, you could definitely still have that chocolate and be good to go.
But you have like the coffee topping with the beans. I mean, this is really nice. And then just the straight.
Just straight solid chocolate.
Look at that, beautiful. Yeah. So you guys, you know, you feed all the sins. Wonderful chocolate.
Exactly.
The bread chef. I mean, they've got all bases covered. They're right here on Western Reserve Road, Southwestern Place, near South Avenue. And I can't thank you. Thank you, Mike. Thank you for having me out.
Yeah, thank you.
And feeding. Oh man, this is great chocolate. You're gonna love it.